Welcome to Control Engineering of 7th semester. We shall discuss on module 2, that is mathematical modeling. We shall continue with our session 4. In this session we will be discussing mainly on DC motors and AC motors used in control systems. Let us first know what are DC motors. DC motors or direct current motors are electromechanical systems which are used in control systems for controlling the position, acceleration and displacement. In these motors, basically the input will be an electrical one and the output will be a mechanical one. DC motors are classified into two types: armature controlled DC motor and field controlled DC motor. In this topics we are supposed to discuss here the transfer function of armature controlled DC motor and field controlled DC motor. Figure shows the parts of a DC motor. It consists of an armature coil which is placed between the magnetic field, the south pole and the north pole of the magnetic field. It has commutator and a brush, and this armature is made, usually this commutator is made up of materials such as copper, and this copper material segment is usually insulated by mica material. The commutator used in this DC motors has a capacity to withstand high temperature of up to 600 degree centigrade. And moving to the next topic, that is transfer function for armature controlled DC motor. The figure shows the DC motor circuit, armature controlled DC motor circuit. In this armature controlled DC motor, the input voltage is applied to the armature with a resistance RA and inductance IA. The field winding is supplied with a constant current IF. Thus, the armature input voltage controls the motor shaft output. So, let us assume few of the terminologies used here. So let here EA is equals to armature voltage. So EA is the armature voltage. Similarly, we have IA, which is called as armature current. Also, RA is the armature resistance and LA is the armature inductance. Let IF be the field current and capital I be the inertia mass. Let capital B be the damping coefficient. In the derivation of the transfer function, we are supposed to make some of the assumptions. So, the assumptions are as below. The first assumption is the flux is directly proportional to the current through field winding. So, the flux is represented as phi is proportional to current, that is IF. So we can remove the proportionality constant, remove constant by Kf. So where Kf is called as field constant. So phi is equals to Kf into If. Let us call this as equation number A. Similarly, we have the second assumption here, that is torque produced by the motor is directly proportional to armature current. So that is T. T is taken as torque. So torque T is proportional to the current IA. So it is nothing but T is equals to K into T of IA. Let us call this as equation B. Here KT is nothing but motor torque constant. The third assumption is back EMF is directly proportional to shaft velocity. So here back EMF is EB is equals to KB into d theta by dt. Let us call this as equation C. Now, applying Kirchhoff's voltage law, that is KVL, to the armature circuit. The circuit which we saw, we apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law and write the equation as EA, that is nothing but the back EMF. EA is equals to armature current, EA is equals to IA RA plus LA into DIA by DT plus EB. Here EB is the back EMF. Therefore, in this equation, we will now substitute the value of back EMF as obtained from equation C. So therefore, the equation reduces to EA is equals to IA RA plus LA DIA by DT plus KB into d theta by dt. Let us call this as equation 1. Now, taking the Laplace transformation for the equation 1, the equation becomes as below. Ea of s is equals to Ia of s into Ra plus La s Ia of s plus Kb s theta s. In this equation, we observe that the term Ia of s is common in the first and the second term. So therefore, the second equation represents after taking the common term Ia of s. Later, after simplifying, we can write the equation in terms of Ea, Kb, s and Ra and La as we get Ia of s is equals to Ea of s minus Kb s theta s divided by Ra plus La of s. Let us call this as equation 2. Now, we know that the torque used for driving the load against inertia and friction is T, which is equals to I theta double dot plus B theta dot. In this equation, we take the Laplace transform for this equation. So, it becomes T of s is equals to I s square theta s plus B s theta s. Again, theta s is common. So, therefore, equation becomes T s is equals to theta s in the square bracket I s square plus B s. Let us call this as equation 3. Now, from the assumptions we made, we have the assumption as T is equals to KT into IA. In this equation, we will take the Laplace transform. So, it becomes T of S is equals to KT IA of S. Let us call this as equation 4. Now, we will substitute the value of 4 in equation 3 so that it becomes KT IA of S is equals to theta S in the bracket I S square plus B S. Let us call this as equation 5. From equation 2, we know that Ia of s is equals to Ea of s minus Kb s theta s divided by Ra plus La of s. Now, we will be substituting equation 2 in equation 5. So, therefore, we get on the left hand side of the equation as Kt into bracket Ea of s minus Kb s theta s divided by Ra plus La of s is equals to theta s into I s square plus B s. Now, we simplify this equation so that we get Kt Ea of s minus Kt Kb s theta s is equals to theta s into I s square plus b s r a plus l a of s. Now, taking the term k t into k b t s theta s to the right hand side, and taking the common terminology that is theta s, the equation reduces to k t a of s is equals to theta s I s square plus b s r a plus l a s plus k t k b s. Therefore, we get the equation that is theta s divided by e a of s, which is nothing but g of s. So this is the transfer function. So transfer function g of s is equals to theta s divided by e a of s is equals to k t divided by I s square plus b s r a plus l a of s plus k t k b s. Now, let us continue with the transfer function of field controlled DC motor. The circuit of a field controlled DC motor is as shown below. So, in the figure we can observe that there are two fields. One is the armature field and the right side we have the armature, magnetic field and the armature field. So the input voltage for control is applied to field with a resistance Rf and inductance If. The armature circuit is supplied with a constant current Ia. Thus, the field input voltage controls the motor shaft output. In the figure, we can see the term constant current source supplied to the armature, which controls the motor shaft output. Here also we have few of the assumptions made. So the assumptions are as below. The first assumption is flux is directly proportional to current through field winding. So that is flux is phi is equals to kf into if, where kf is called as field constant. The second assumption is torque produced by the motor is directly proportional to field current. So torque T is equals to KT into IA. So these are the two assumptions. In this equation, KT is called as motor torque constant. Let us now call the first equation as A, and let the second equation be called as B. Similarly, there is another assumption, that is the back EMF is not generated as armature is not connected to field circuit. So here we do not have any back EMF generated since the armature is not connected to field circuit. So now we apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law to the armature circuit, and so therefore we get EF is equals to IFRF plus LF DIF by DT. Now we take the Laplace transform for the equation. So it becomes EF of S is equals to IF of S RF plus LF S IF of S. In these two terms, we find IF of S is a common term. So therefore, taking it as a common term, the equation is written as EF of S is equals to IF of S in the bracket RF plus LF S. So therefore, we can write the equation as IF of S is equals to EF of S divided by RF plus LFS. Let us call this as equation 1. Now, we know that the torque used for driving the motor against inertia and friction is T is equals to I theta dot plus B theta dot. Now we take the Laplace transform for this equation. So the equation becomes t of s is equals to is square theta s plus bs theta s. Again, the equation is obtained by taking the theta s as common, and equation reduces to ts is equals to theta of s is square plus bs. Let us call this as equation 2. From the assumptions made, we know that one of the assumption, that is the assumption, second assumption, we know that t is equals to kt if, which is nothing but the torque developed by the motor. For this equation B, we take the Laplace transform, so the equation reduces to ts is equals to kt if s. Let us call this as equation 3. Now, equating equation 2 and equation 3, we can write kt into if s is equals to theta s is square plus bs. Let us call this as equation 4. From equation 1, we know that if of s is equals to ef of s divided by rf plus lf of s. So here we now substitute equation 1 in equation 4. So therefore we get kt into ef of s divided by rf plus lf of s is equals to theta of s into is square plus bs. In this equation, we now multiply kt with the term in the numerator and cross multiply the term in the denominator with the term on the right hand side. So therefore, the equation becomes kt ef of s is equals to theta s is square plus bs rf plus lf s. Therefore, the transfer function is g of s is equals to theta of s divided by ef of s is equals to kt divided by is square plus bs rf plus lf s. This is the derivation for the transfer function of field controlled DC motor. Now we will have a quick overlook over the advantages and the applications of DC motors. Few of the advantages of DC motors are: DC motors can operate directly from rechargeable batteries. So this advantage of DC motors makes it a motive power for the first electric vehicles and the today's hybrid cars and electric cars, and they are also used, because of this advantage, they are used in driving a host of cordless tools also. Few of the applications of DC motors are: they are used in toys and disk drives. Toys and disk drives make use of DC motors. They are also used in large sizes to operate the steel rolling mills and paper machines also. Larger DC motors are also used in propulsion of electric vehicles, elevators and hoists, or in drives for steel rolling mills. Elevators and hoists or in drives for steel rolling mills also make use of DC motors. Now we shall discuss on another type of motor called as alternating current motor or AC motor. The AC motors consists of various parts as shown in the figure. The two major parts of an AC motor are a stator and a rotor. Stator is nothing but a stationary part, and rotor is the one which always has a rotary movement. We shall now discuss regarding the transfer function for this AC motor. Figure shows the circuit of an AC motor. The stator carries two windings which are located at a 90 degrees phase angle. So in the figure we can see there are two windings which are placed at 90 degrees to each other. The first one is called as reference winding and the second one is called as control winding, which are perpendicular to each other. Reference winding is excited by constant AC voltage supply. So it has constant AC supply, and control winding is excited by variable control voltage from a servo amplifier. The voltage is 90 degree out of phase with respect to voltage applied at reference winding. We have few assumptions in this AC motor. The assumptions are, the first assumption is AC motor rarely operates at high speed and are used for low power applications. So with this assumption we can write it as T is proportional to N, and T is proportional to d theta by dt, which is nothing but T is equals to m into d theta by dt. The second assumption is torque T and motor speed N are directly proportional to the applied voltage. They are directly proportional. So therefore T is proportional to N and T is proportional to V C winding. So here T is proportional to EC, or T is equals to Km into EC. Here Km indicates it is a motor torque constant, and theta in the first assumption indicates it is the angular displacement of the shaft. The term M indicates it is a motor speed constant. M indicates it is a motor speed constant. Now we can write the theoretical torque developed by the motor as T is equals to Km EC plus M into d theta by dt. Here we take the Laplace transform for this equation. So therefore TS is equals to Km EC of S plus MS theta of S, and this equation is called as equation 1. Now we know that the torque used for driving motor against inertia and friction is given by T is equals to I theta double dot plus B theta dot. Taking Laplace transform for the equation becomes T of S is equals to I S square theta of S plus B S theta of S. So therefore, taking the common term, the equation becomes T of S is equals to theta of S I S square plus B S. Let us call this as equation 2. Now we equate equation 1 and equation 2. So therefore Km EC of S plus MS theta of S plus MS theta of S is equals to theta of S into IS square plus BS. Here, the equation is simplified by taking the terms involving theta of S on one side. So, plus MS theta S is taken to the right hand side, and the equation is written once again by taking theta of S as common, and therefore we get Km EC of S is equals to theta of S into bracket IS square plus BS minus MS. Now G of S is nothing but the transfer function. So therefore transfer function is equals to theta of S divided by EC of S, which is equals to Km divided by IS square plus BS minus MS. Again, we observe that the term S can be taken as a common in the denominator on the right hand side. So therefore, equation becomes the transfer function G of S is equals to theta of S divided by EC of S, which is equals to Km divided by S into IS plus B minus M. Now, divide and multiply the denominator by B minus M. So therefore, we get theta S divided by EC of S is equals to Km divided by S into B minus M into IS divided by B minus M plus B minus M divided by B minus M. So only thing, we have multiplied and divided by B minus M in the denominator. So here we get the simplified equation as theta of S divided by EC of S is equals to Km divided by S into B minus M into IS divided by B minus M plus 1. So this is about the transfer function of the AC motor. Now we assume that the term I divided by B minus M as a term called as tau M, which is nothing but the motor constant. So therefore, the equation can also be now be written as the transfer function G of S is equals to theta of S divided by EC of S is equals to Km divided by S into B minus M into S tau M plus 1. Now we will have a quick discussion on the advantages, disadvantages and applications of AC motors. The major advantages of AC motors are: they are low cost, they have less weighted inertia, they have higher efficiency, and they have fewer maintenance compared to the DC motors. Why fewer maintenance is involved in case of AC motors? It is only because that they do not have any commutator and brushes as in case of DC motors. And hence, the maintenance is comparatively lesser here. The disadvantages are: it is difficult to control AC motors for position requirements, especially in case of positioning applications. It is very difficult to control these AC motors. This is a major disadvantage of the AC motors. Few of the applications where AC motors find use are: they are used in low power applications such as in instrument servos, example control of pen in XY recorders, and they are also used in computer related equipments such as disk drives, tape drives, printers, etc. Let us now discuss about the multiple choice questions on the topics that we cover today. The first multiple choice question is, which part of the DC motor can sustain maximum temperature rise? The options given are armature winding, second option is field winding, the third option is slip ring, the fourth option is commutator. We know that the DC motor has a commutator which is made up of copper material. It is made up of copper segments, and this copper segment is insulated by mica material. Mica is a ceramic material which has a capacity to withstand high temperature up to 600 degree centigrade. So therefore the term commutator in case of DC motor is the one which can sustain maximum temperature rise, and hence the right answer is option D, that is commutator. Coming to the second multiple choice question, in which of the following applications DC series motor is used? The options given are A, centrifugal pump, B, motor operation in DC and AC, C, water pump drive, D, starter for car. As when we discuss the applications of DC motors, they are majorly used for high power applications, and these DC motors have a capacity of torque which is proportional to the square of the armature current. This property makes the DC motors to be used for starters in case of cars, since they can provide the high starting torque which is required for starting a car. So the DC motors have the capacity to provide the high torque that is required for starting a car, and hence they are used in starters for car. So therefore the right option will be option D, starter for car. The third multiple choice question is, the direction of rotation of DC motor can be changed by option A, interchanging supply terminals, option B, interchanging field terminals, option C, both A and B, option D, none of the above. We know that the various parts of a DC motor, while discussing, we find that the DC armature coil is being placed between two terminals, that is the south pole and the north pole of the magnetic field. So if we interchange which of the following among the options given, the direction of rotation of DC motor can be changed. So it is nothing but if we interchange the field terminals, then definitely the direction of rotation of DC motor can be changed. So among the options given, the right option will be option B, interchanging field terminals, whereas the other options are not hold good. The fourth multiple choice question is, AC motors are used in option A, low power and computer related applications, option B, rolling mills and paper machines, option C, both of the above, option D, none of the above. While discussing the applications of AC motors and DC motors, we discuss that DC motors are used for high power applications such as rolling mills and paper machines, whereas AC motors are used in low power applications and computer related applications. So therefore the options given, that is option D, none of the above. So that is that cannot be the right choice. Even option C cannot be the right choice because both options cannot hold good for AC motors. So therefore, the right option will be option A, that is low power and computer related applications. Option A will be the right answer. With this, we come to the end of this session. Thank you.